So the first thing I did to solve this problem was to draw a force diagram. So we know the force of gravity is pulling down on the car, like we'd expect, and there's some normal force pointing upwards. And since the car isn't accelerating vertically, we know these two forces must balance each other out perfectly. And of course we have the frictional force, which we've said is equal to bv squared, and we've got the force that the car is producing to make it go forward. And this force is actually produced by the road pushing up on the wheels. By Newton's third law, the wheels push on the ground, and the ground pushes back up on the wheels, causing the car to move forward. And we know that if the car is going at its maximum speed and can't go any faster, then these two forces should be perfectly balanced too. So we can say that this force here equals this force over here. So starting with the equation for work, I divide both sides by delta t, and you'll note that this term, delta d, the change in position, over the change in time, well, that's just the same as velocity. And also over here, work divided by change in time, that's just the same thing as power. So we get this nice equation that power is equal to the force pushing the car forward times its velocity. Now what's this F equal to? Well, we said earlier that this F has to perfectly balance out the frictional force. So we know that the frictional force is equal to bv squared, so we can just plug that in. And multiplying that by the v, we get that the power is equal to bv cubed. And solving for velocity, we get that the velocity required to go at a constant speed at a certain power is equal to the cube root of the power divided by that constant b. And plugging in the numbers we were given, it turns out that 150 horsepower is equal to 111,000 watts. We get that the maximum speed you can go is 103.8 meters per second. And if you're curious, that's about equal to 232 miles per hour. Of course, in the real world, we're not just dealing with air friction, we're dealing with all sorts of friction. So this value might be a little higher than you'd expect. But if you got this value, congratulations on solving the problem.